Exactly 40 years ago tonight, TV8 viewers sat down to watch 6 o'clock news. What they witnessed was one of the most shocking videos ever recorded in Cleveland television history.
The classic confrontation between the city's most powerful politician, George Forbes, and ITM reporter Carl Monday. Tonight, Carl looks back at the legendary encounter.
The morning of February 13th, 1984.
George, you got 1 second? I just want to ask you a question.
I approached then City Council President George Forbes outside the council committee room about his delinquent $440 water and sewer bill.
But it says here you haven't paid your bill in a year.
That's what you said. I'm not aware of that. No big problem, you know. City ain't gonna go bankrupt.
To be fair, Forbes wasn't the only water bill deadbeat.
At a time when the city of Cleveland's walking a financial tightrope, tens of millions of dollars in delinquent water and sewer bills are going uncollected.
In fact, future mayor Mike White owed $1,700. A local brewery, $600,000. But it was Forbes' vulgar and tone-deaf rant that triggered a media firestorm.
Well, don't you think it's a bad example to set?
No, I do not. I don't have the money.
You don't have money to pay a $400 water bill?
I do not have the money, okay? Did you hear me?
Forbes, a well-connected, successful lawyer and businessman, continued to plead poverty.
I do not have the money.
You say you don't have money to pay your bill.
Did you hear me?
But your water's still on, though, isn't it?
Yeah.
We pressed the right button there, or the wrong button.
It was.
Russ Herbrook was a longtime Fox 8 photographer. For the first time in 40 years, we sat down and watched the confrontation that Russ recorded for posterity.
When we aired it, it was the censored version. And when you see the uncensored version, it's shocking.
Yeah.
You have to admit, it's shocking.
As the I-team reported at the time, the city was quick to shut off service to delinquent water customers. But somehow, the water was still running at the home of Cleveland's most prominent politician.
The city hasn't disconnected his service. You'll find the homeowner's name a familiar one, City Council President George Forbes.
And I think the audacity of the fact that he saw nothing wrong with it, because you asked him.
Yeah.
Point blank.
Don't you think your water should be turned off if you're not paying your
bill? No, it should not be.
Turned out, Forbes and other council members bypassed the normal appeals process to be put on a payment plan with the city.
It wasn't just the fact that he didn't pay his bill, it's that he got special treatment.
Yes. And that was the point you were trying to make.
A minute, 5 seconds in, Forbes decided to cut the confrontation short to head up a committee hearing, ironically, to discuss the city's dire finances. Our water bill discussion was over, but not for long.
I knew in that first confrontation that he was coming back.
You just had a feeling.
Just had a feeling.
You know, one of these days, you're going to corner me, and I'm going to kick your ass.
So Russ kept rolling.
You know, one of these days, you're going to corner me, and I'm going to kick your ass.
Well, don't you think that's a legitimate question, George? I mean, you're not the only counselor. You're not the only counselor.
Wait a minute. I gave you an legitimate answer. You asked me about my water bill. What did I tell you?
Said you didn't have the money. But your water's still on, isn't it?
Now, that was my answer to you.
But I don't think everybody has that luxury of having their water
tough.
By now, a crowd had begun to gather. Among them, a then young councilman, Mike Polencik.
I'm standing there saying, George, knock him out. That's what I'm hoping.
knock me out.
Knock Carl out. Knock Carl on his ass. That's what we're hoping for.
One of these days you're gonna corner me and I'm gonna kick your ass. Now keep with me, okay? Now I'm telling you, keep with me.
You're not the only one, George.
I'm not talking about anybody else but you.
First of all, as you know, Carl, you were an irritant. You were like the political hemorrhoid that a lot of people didn't want to have.
Now I gave you a damn answer.
And I asked you a follow-up question.
I gave you a answer.
But then on the other side, there were some people who say, well, maybe if George knocks him out, he'll get indicted and we'll get rid of him.
So now one of these days, I'm gonna kick your ass, George. And it might be this damn one. Now you got your answer. Now get out of my damn face.
Thank you.
Media reaction to Forbes' outburst came fast and furious. TV8 editorial director Herb Kam called it a new low in public behavior.
News Center 8 has received hundreds of protests from outraged viewers about Forbes' conduct.
The calls began immediately after Forbes' assault on Carl Monday and on the sensitivities of our viewers.
We'll check again tomorrow and each and every day until the bill is paid.
Forbes did pay his water bill about 2 weeks later. He may have also paid a political price, telling others the public outburst contributed to his defeat in the mayor's race 5 years later.
I always thought that I could.
In a 2013 interview with PD columnist Brent Larkin, the family man and former Sunday school teacher expressed regrets.
Your language got the best of you in public at times.
The one thing I would have changed, the language.
Few may remember, but just weeks before our confrontation, a reporter that Forbes law firm represented an adult bookstore a business officials were trying to shut down on Brook Park Road. No doubt, George's blood was already boiling by the time I grilled him about the water bill.
I remember it as though it was yesterday.
As time passed, Forbes often joked that he deserved the Emmy for the water bill story, not me. And he may be right. 15 years after the story aired, I knocked on his door and presented him with the Emmy statue. Today, the confrontation lives on social media. By one estimate, 4 million views. Accomplished guitarist Mono Neon even put it to music.
I do not have the money.
These days, Forbes spends much of his time in Florida. When in town, I may run into him and share a good laugh over an improbable bond we share over 2 minutes and 49 seconds of TV magic from 40 years ago.
I ain't bull with you. Now, I'll take that camera and wrap it around your damn head. Now, one of these days, you're going to grab me the wrong minute. No, I give you my answer, okay?
Okay.
We got to meet.
I ain't bullshitting with you.
We got to meet.
It was the man, the most powerful man in Cleveland City politics, against the most prominent investigative reporter in the city of Cleveland at the time.
Now, you scared him, but I'll kick your damn ass. Well, I ain't bullshitting with you.
We got to meet.
Son of a.
It was the clash of the titans.
Hang around with me if you want. Now, you think I'm bullshitting with you?
Carl Monday, Fox 8 I-Team.
Carl, thank you. Well, Forbes respectfully declined to be interviewed for this story. Now 92 years old, his family says that he is not up to doing interviews these days. So why didn't Forbes pay his $440 water bill? Well, George once told Carl Monday, perhaps jokingly, that his wife used the money to buy a new fur coat.
One of the most memorable moments, certainly, in the history of Cleveland TV. Yeah.